Hello friends, I am D K and I welcome you all in a technical analysis series. Today we are going to discuss the very important aspect of, probably the most important aspect of trading as a business, risk and money management. Let me emphasize that probably this is the most neglected area by large sum of traders across the globe. Let's understand that trading is a business like any other business, and if any trade that you take is not in your control with regard to pre-calculated risk and the possibility of target or profit within the overall capital in your trading account, the great risk is involved. So let us understand this very important aspect of risk and money management, which is key to success in trading business. Before I begin, you are requested to go through the disclaimer. Let's understand, like any other business, there are two important elements in trading business as well. One is the risk involved. Another, you intend to enter into the business with the aim to make profit. So, there is a risk involved, and against that risk, you are trying to make profit. Let me emphasize further that no technical analyst in the world can be right all the time while making analysis. And hence it becomes very, very essential to have a proper risk and money management in place. Since no technical analyst in the world can be right all the time, and even if you are right 45 to 50% and work with positive expectancy, you will end up making money. Technical analysis has a distinct advantage. It gives us an edge over others who are doing or taking trades without any technical analysis, which helps us to run the trading business effectively. Therefore, we must make a strategy based on technical analysis and risk and money management, which is pre-decided before we enter into a trade. Let me define certain rules of trading. And we should ensure that we rigidly follow these rules. The first step is we must make a thorough and detailed analysis on price chart and calculate the stop loss and the target. This is the first step. We analyze the price chart of a particular stock or index and arrive at a stop loss and target, which means when we enter the trade, we have only two times we make an exit. One, either the stop loss is triggered or the target is achieved. So this becomes the exit strategy. Now, once we have calculated the stop loss and target, we calculate the risk reward ratio, which is nothing but we calculate what is the risk involved based on a stop loss and what is the possibility of making profit against the target. And hence, this ratio becomes very, very important to ensure that we work with certain positive expectancy. It is said and well adopted practice worldwide that one should not enter into a trade with risk reward ratio less than 1:2, which means if I am likely to make loss on trigger of a stop loss of 1 rupee, there should be a possibility of making profit of 2 rupees against the trade. So we should ensure that we only enter into a trade where risk reward ratio is 1:2 or more. The third step is that we should not risk 1% to 2% of the capital in a single trade. We will look into this aspect with an example and calculations in subsequent slide. Once these steps are done, once these calculations are done, we need to implement our exit strategy without any deviation. That means we either exit at a loss when a stop loss is triggered, or we exit at a profit when target is achieved. In only these two conditions, we make an exit rather than we decide exit and entry on the basis of emotions and gut feeling. Let me see and tell you what are the advantages of minimum risk reward ratio, that is triple R, of 1:2, that is a minimum. For example, if I have made an analysis and as per the stop loss, I lose rupees 10 per share, and while as per the target, I make 20 rupees as a profit per share. And considering that I am only right to an extent of 50% on my analysis. Although it will be more than that as you learn technical analysis and master it and improve upon it with the time, it will be as high as 65 to 70%. However, considering that only 50% of the trades results into a profitable trade. So for example, if I do 100 trades and my stop loss is triggered in 50 trades and my profit is achieved in 50 trades. So in each trade, I lose in 50 trades, I lose at the rate of 10 rupees per share, 500 rupees. While whenever I exit in a profit, I make 20 rupees profit each share against the 50 trades. So I make a profit of 1000 rupees. So in case of loss, in overall 50 trades, I lose 500 rupees, and in 50 trades, I make 1000 rupees. Therefore, my net profit is rupees 1000 minus rupees 500. So it is very important that we do not enter into a trade where risk reward ratio is less than 1:2. Let us see this example. This is the chart of Kotak Bank on NSE India based on today's closing price. And let us see that we have done an analysis that this particular stock has given a breakout of symmetrical triangle. This is the symmetrical triangle which has been drawn. This is the breakout of symmetrical triangle. Accordingly, I have calculated the target, which comes at 1422.75, while a stop loss should be below this support line, So, which is at 1152. As per the trade management, we should make an entry above the high of today's candle to avoid fake breakout. So we have planned an entry at entry price is 1268 and stop loss is 1152. So which calculates that this is the risk involved per share. So 1268, which is our entry price minus stop loss 1152, calculates to 116. Means 116 rupees I am likely to lose each share, while my profit each share comes to target, that is 1422.75 minus entry price, that is 154.75. Now let us calculate the risk reward ratio. Means this is the risk involved is 116. So 116 divided by probable profit, that is 154.75. So risk reward ratio calculates to 0.75, which means I am taking a risk of 1 rupee to make 75 naya paisa. So this risk reward ratio is less than 1:2. And hence, although this stock has given a breakout as per technical analysis, but this stock is not giving the favorable risk reward ratio, and hence I will not enter into this trade as per my rule. Let's see another example with calculation of risk reward ratio. This is the daily chart of Divi's Lab on NSC India based on today's closing price. Now, if we see that this stock were consolidated in this particular range and has given a clear-cut breakout today, this is the breakout candle. So, this is the breakout of a flag pattern. And hence, according to technical analysis, after other aspects consideration, we have arrived at a target of 1771.4, while stop loss at 1439, which is little below the swing low. And hence, my risk per share calculates to this much, which is 96.5, which is entry price minus stop loss 96.5, against which, if my target is achieved, how much profit I am going to make is 1771.4, which is the target, minus my entry price. So this calculates to 235.9. Now let us calculate the risk reward ratio. Risk reward ratio is probable profit divided by risk per share, which calculates to 2.44, which means for each rupee of loss I am going to take in this trade, I am likely to make 2.4 rupees. And hence, risk reward ratio is favorable. It is more than 1:2. And hence, I am going to take this trade. So, let us further see how we do the trade management, considering the risk management and money management. Now, based on the analysis done in the previous slide, our entry price is 1535.5, our risk per share is 96.5 per share, profit per share has been calculated as 235.9. Now these are the basic inputs. based on technical analysis that we have arrived. Now, considering your capital in your trading account is rupees 6 lakhs. It will vary from person to person, and hence it is very important to decide what is the trading capital. What is the capital in the trading account is nothing but cash in the trading account plus value of shares held in demat account is the trading capital. As we have decided that we will not risk more than 1% to 2% per trade or a single trade, so let us take an example with lower limit, that is 1% risk per trade. So 1% of my capital calculates to 6,000 rupees. Now, what should be the quantity I should buy? General practice in the marketplace is that people buy a quantity without any calculations. They will buy of 1 lakh rupee or 50,000 rupees or 2 lakhs rupees of a particular trade. There where we compromise with our management of the trade. So quantity to be bought would be 1% of the capital, that is 6,000 rupees in this example, divided by risk per share is equal to 6,000 rupees divided by risk per share, which we have arrived on the basis of technical analysis. So it calculates to 62 share. In this example, and based on analysis, 62 shares. That means value of the purchase as per the planned strategy would be 62 into our entry price 1535.5. This is the entry price which has been planned. So value of purchase would be 95,201 rupees. So what will be the maximum loss if I exit? In case my stop loss is triggered, it will be 62 into 96.5, which is a loss per share multiplied by number of shares that I have bought. So it calculates to 5,983. That means in this particular trade management, if my capital is 6 lakhs rupees, I am taking a risk of only 5,983 rupees. Against this, what is the possible target which I am targeting? If my target is achieved based on technical analysis is 62 multiplied by 235.9, that is 14,625.8. So this is a positive expectancy against the loss of 5,983. I am targeting to make 14,625.8. This is business. Dear friends, अगर आपको presentation पसंद आया हो, तो जरूर like करें, share करें, and channel अगर आपने subscribe नहीं किया है, तो channel को subscribe करें, and इस family के size को बढ़ाएं, ताकि we can create a platform which is interactive among the beginners, traders and experienced technical analysts. Thank you very much and thanks for watching.